Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of Storytale Cakes. In this episode, I'm going to be showing you how to make a semi-naked cake with chocolate gold drips and how to safely put flowers into your cake. So without further ado, shall we get started? So here I have three pre-baked 7-inch cakes. For making naked cakes, I don't like to kind of like cut the edges of it because it's more easier to work with when it has a, like a caramelized edge. So just for naked cakes, don't trim the edges. You can trim the top, but leave the sides because it's much easier to apply the buttercream. So here I've cut out a small piece of non-stick mat just to help keep the 7-inch board in place. I'm just applying a bit of buttercream to help stick the cake as well. And now going to frost it with some delicious strawberry buttercream. Link will be in the description box below. And I'm just going to finish the second layer with another generous layer of frosting. So for our final layer, we want to have the bottom side of the cake facing up and the bottom side facing downwards, because the bottom side is usually the more flatter side. If you put on this side, you can see that it's not as flat as the bottom side. And the main thing you want to do here is kind of like push down the cake. Use a bit of the muscles, not really muscles, but just push it down, because if you don't push it down, I find that when you're transporting the cake, the cream here will kind of like split out like this, and you don't want that on your cake. So make sure you push it down so all the excess buttercream can kind of slide out as well.
So now I'm just applying frosting to the outer layer of the cake. I find that it's easier to put a lot of frosting on the cake first before you spread it with a spatula scraper, as it prevents cake crumbs going into the frosting.
So when the cake here is caramelized on the outside, it makes it a lot easier to apply your buttercream, because your buttercream doesn't really take away the crumbs with it.
As you reach the end, just use a spatula and pull the frosting to the center to get a nice clean edge look.
So now I'm gonna put this in the fridge for 20 minutes to set and prep for our gold drips.
Use a bit of melted chocolate to adhere onto your presentation board. Handy tip, add only a bit of in the center because the weight of the cake will spread the chocolate out further. To get that complete smooth look on your cake, dip the spatula or scraper into warm to hot water, not boiling water, and go around it over your cake until it's smooth. Repeat the steps to the top of the cake as well. To make our chocolate drip, I'm just using 150 grams of chocolate to 75 milliliters of cream melted together in the microwave. I then place my piping bag in a cup and pour the chocolate ganache into it. Depending how thick you want your drips to be, you can trim the bag between half a centimeter to a centimeter from the tip. I trimmed about 75 millimeters. Apply chocolate to the edges of your cake and add pressure to the piping bag where you want the drips to fall. Just remember, don't add too much pressure because the chocolate will eventually drip down when gravity does its magic for us. After you finish your drips, you want to swirl the remaining ganache around the top of your cake and use a spatula to even it out. Make sure you work quickly, as chocolate sets fast on a cold cake.
So now I'm going to put this in the fridge, or even I'd say freezer, for about 5 to 10 minutes, just so the chocolate can set before we start painting on our gold colour. So there's two ways to prep flowers on your cake. You can use one of these posy picks with water. I like to use this option when I have to leave the cake out for like a day or a bit more than a day, or like if it's a really hot weather, then I'd like to make sure that the flower still has a bit of water and it's stored inside a posy pick. A simpler method you can use is if you're going to serve the cake on the day and the weather's like, you know, not too hot, you can just get one of these like pliers, cut it from the real tip of it, actually about here, and using a toothpick, you're just gonna poke it through the bottom stem. After that, you still need to use a bit of wax-proof paper. Don't use the paper ones because it's not waterproof, and sometimes the roses kind of leaks out water there as well. So just gonna press it and then smooth it out and then apply it on the edge of the rose, and then going upwards. Push it up at least a centimeter from the actual stem. And there you have it, your rose. So this option or this option. So hot weather, cold weather, on the same day, but you can, I guess the only downside of this one is it's a bit bulky when you put in your cake and you have to kind of try to cover it. Whereas this one, it looks more natural and you can't really see the bulk. I like both, but up to you depending on the weather.
So I have Rolglim Super Gold Edible Dust and I'm just gonna put a little bit of it into the center of my palette. And I'm also using some Cake Decorator's Rose Spirit. This is the best type of alcohol to use because it has a higher alcohol content, making it less streakier when you paint it on the cake.
I find that if you pour the alcohol bottle directly into the luster dust, you may risk over pouring it. So I recommend using an eyedrop bottle and add a few drops at a time instead. So it's at a good consistency when it's thin, but not too thin, just like this. So this cake has actually been set in the freezer for about 5 to 10 minutes. It's really important you do this because if your chocolate is still not set yet, you'll find that if you put the gold powder on, it'll kind of just go bleh, like that. So you want to make sure it's all set. So I'm going to put the gold on now. Have a look.
Paint in one direction so it's more even. This is my favorite part because I just love seeing the transition to that golden gorgeous color.
I'm using these little fanny brushes. Is it a fanny brush? Oh my gosh, okay. I like using these. Okay, I don't know what brush this is called, but I presume it's like a broom brush or something. So now on the sides, I'm going to just feather it out a little bit. Not going to do it on the drips because the drips need a thinner brush.
So with the thinner brush, I'm just painting the side drips. I highly recommend investing in a brush with soft bristles so you don't scratch your chocolate whilst painting. It's an optional step. You can add a bit of edible gold leaf to your cake for the extra golden glamorous touch. Use your paintbrush to pat down any excess gold leaf that's still sticking out. When placing the flour into the cake, make sure you place only the unwrapped toothpick part and not the green part. However, if you do decide to do the posy pick option, then because it's free from tape, you can actually push it flush down to the cake.
Thanks for watching, guys. I hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial. If you do happen to make this creation, please hashtag StoryTellCakes on Instagram. I'd love to see and share. Please subscribe and I'll see you soon. Mmm.